Hey Aries, hope you guys have been having a really good September. Today we're going to go into your October 2018 forecast. And basically what I'm feeling for you is you guys are feeling a little bit stressed, and that's because things aren't really working out the way that you want them to. And whenever you look at that, it can feel stressful and it can feel disappointing. And the way that you're coping with that is you are trying to get excited about things. You're trying to manufacture this feeling of excitement about things to come and about maybe your disappointments. You're trying to see them in a way that makes it seem exciting to you. And normally I would say that this isn't really the best approach. I would say that the best approach is to actually address your emotions of frustration and disappointment and stress. And through that, you will be able to truly feel excited versus feeling stress and ignoring it and pretending like it doesn't exist and then pretending to be happy instead. But I really feel like whatever it is that you're doing in this realm, it is really working for you. And so continue to be excited, continue to think in that term, in those ways, because I really feel like it's working out for you. And I think that if you continue to do that, you will leave October doing really well. And I feel like there are some good opportunities coming your way, and when you see them, you're going to recognize them and you're going to be like, this is it, and you're going to go for it. And those opportunities are going to be some really, really solid opportunities that are really going to push you forward in your life. And this is interesting because I think it was Aries at the very beginning of the year where you guys were kind of swaying in the wind. You didn't really know who you were or what you really wanted, and so when one opportunity came your way, you went after that. And then when another opportunity came your way, even though it didn't really fit into your overall plan, you went with that because you didn't really know what your overall plan was. I think that was Aries. And so I feel like you guys have really come such a long way, because when the opportunities come to you in October, you know, you feel it, you know it's the right thing to do. You don't second guess, you don't question, you go right for it. And so I think that's really awesome. So I actually see that this momentum of these really good opportunity, because I think you're going to pursue it and I think it's going to be a really good one, I see that momentum being able to carry you through a few months. Like if you stick with this could really be something that you continue with and stick with and could become something. Now the only thing that I see though is that I think at the end of October there is going to be somebody in your life who maybe distracts you or can distract you. I'm getting like a younger sibling feel, but I don't think it has to be a younger sibling, but it's kind of like how a younger sibling can kind of cause some like trouble in your life. And so I think that whoever this person is, that maybe you should spend as little time with them as possible, because they are going to distract you and take you away from your focus and your goals. And I almost feel like if you do that, then you may not really have to deal with them in November, and then you won't have to deal with them for most of December, except for like if they're younger sibling, whenever you have your family Christmas get together, and then it's kind of awkward because they're mad at you for ignoring them and not really being there for them, and you kind of have to gel together. And I feel like this is really weird advice, to ignore somebody just because they bother you. And it's not really advice I would normally suggest, but I feel like it actually would make you a lot happier, because I think you've been there for this person and they tend to really stress you out a lot more than you need to be stressed out, and they kind of make you unhappy. And yeah, like Christmas time or whenever you see them in December could be a little bit awkward, but at the same time, like if it is a family situation, you guys are going to be around your parents and you're both going to have to be on your best behavior, and that means this person as well. And so they can only be pouty, they can't really like act out about it. And I just feel like it's such a weird conversation to tell you guys to do this to your siblings or whoever this person is, but that is what I'm getting. And I feel like this is a good opportunity for them to really take this time away from you, where they're going to be annoyed, but like the space is good for them, because over this time, and I think maybe it'll take a little bit past December, they're going to have to come to terms with how they make you feel and how they are contributing to the situation of you trying to kind of avoid them in the short term, and really kind of reflect on that and possibly own up to that, and then maybe come to you with some kind of apology. And I don't know that they necessarily did anything specific, but I think that they maybe need to really consider how they're affecting your lives and maybe be more conscious of their relationship with you and how maybe they should show up differently when they are with you, so that you both can be happy in your connection together and you get something out of this as well, or you feel happy whenever you see them versus trying to avoid them. So it's kind of weird advice, but I feel like they need this time as well to kind of reflect on what's going on. And in the meantime, you can really focus on the things that are going well and get excited about them and really try to take this opportunity that you're going to get in October and pull it through to the end of the year as much as possible and try to make the most of it. So that's what I get for you guys in October. Thank you guys for watching, and I will see you guys in my next video.